Hi, I'm Henning and today we are building stairs, platform and railings using SolidSteel for Creo Elements Direct. The complete unit will look like this in the end of the video. This is the final part of the three-part series. In the first part the framework was built, in the second part the tank and the pipes. This time we will take care about comfort and safety. With the help of SolidSteel this is no problem because railings and stairs are constructed with it in no time. Let's start! In order to do maintenance work, it is necessary to be able to safely reach the upper level of the framework. The framework has a height of 2.5 meters and the easiest way to overcome this is to use stairs. To add a stairway, we use the tool with the same name. The stair menu opens and the first thing we do is to define the height direction so that SolidSteel knows that we want to go up there. This is followed by the definition of the walking direction. Both is done easily with a few clicks. Next, the menu asks for the endpoint of the stairs and in this case it is at the top of this beam. Pressing Ctrl and Shift ensures that the center point is selected and that the staircase is inserted centered. A small distance should be included and move the stair preview half a meter away from the framework. Now we can confirm the settings by clicking on the green tick. That was quick, but of course we are not yet satisfied with the result. To connect the top of the stairs to the frame, we use the same U profile as the stair stringers. We define the outer edge as the starting point and extend the new profile into the existing framework. The exact adjustments are made later and for now we turn the profile 180 degrees in the right direction and align the axis flush at the top. We do the same on the other side. At the bottom of the staircase we also add profiles and use the existing column as a reference for the direction. Since the added profiles still overlap, we use the adjust tool, select the profile and then the surface to which the length should be adjusted. Down here it is done exactly the same way, as a reference for the height we use the bottom of an existing column. So the lengths are now correct and the intersections of the beam certainly look fancy, but we better add miters. To do that, we use the cut diagonal tool where we just select the two profiles to apply the miter cut and then confirm. We do the same at the remaining locations. To connect the staircase to the framework, we take angle connections and the tool here also has the matching name. To create the connection, the beams to be connected are selected and then confirmed. This one step also automatically adds the bolted connections and the required notches. Convenient, isn't it? The staircase is ready. We can now take care of a suitable platform. We will design the platform as a grating and to define the geometry, we first create a working plane to draw the corresponding sketch on it. The existing components are used to project the sketch onto the plane. Now we have finished the auxiliary geometry and can hide the model with pressing F5 to get a better overview. We can simply trace the desired surface for the later platform with the line and arc tool. To have room for the railings later on, we select the center of the outer beams and finish the lines at the tank for now. The claw in the middle is outlined with the same tool. For the circle segments, we use the overdraw tool. This would set the geometry of the platform and pressing F5 will bring the model back in. Back in the SolidSteel tab, we find the grating tool in the drop-down menu at Stairways. Now we just have to select the work surface, change the parameters for the grating if necessary and confirm. The software calculates for a moment and we have our platform. Our working plane is no longer needed and can be deleted. This already looks good, but you can still easily fall down the platform and stairs. We need a railing. Fortunately, SolidSteel also offers the right tools for this. Using the railing construction framework, which can be found in the railing drop-down menu, we start this task. I begin at the claw. Simply click on the edge, specify the offset, in my case 120 mm to the center, and define the desired height. To get a post on a short claw, the post spacing must be changed to a smaller value. Selecting the edge of the next beam extends the railing construction framework. Since the parameters of the last section are inherited, the offset, height and the post spacing must now be adjusted here. With further clicks on the edges, we simply follow the contour to which we want to add a railing. Now we see the preview, which we confirm. We switch to the post tool, which we find again in the submenu of railing. Here we could define the type of posts as we prefer. For me the settings are okay and I place the first one. To do this, I first click on the connection surface and then on the reference edge. Here we now see that the connector plate is oriented incorrectly, which is quickly corrected by clicking on another reference edge. While we are at it, we can also place the post exactly in the center of the claw. We confirm the placement and then click Create. The first post, including the bolted connection, is now inserted and the tool is immediately ready for inserting further posts. We now follow the railing construction framework we just created. We only need to correct the placement manually if there is an overlap between the profile and the connecting plate, as it is the case here. The stair stringer is based on a C profile and thus has a surface on the inside that is not parallel to the top surface. Therefore, SolidSteel asks if a wedge washer should be used to compensate for the slope. I think it's a good idea and confirm. Now we can continue placing posts as usual. You may have noticed that there is a small practical problem with the connecting plates when using a standard plate with the stairs. Due to the angle between the post and the plate, the screw on the upper side cannot be inserted into the hole as drawn here. This is a common problem in such places and should be considered by the designer so that the metal workers do not make jokes about us. There are several solutions here. We could, for example, provide a different connection plate that is either longer at the top or shortened and then fastened only on the lower side. However, I just twist the screw around in the drawing because that's exactly what the craftsman would also do on the construction site. Now that we have clarified this detail, the handrail is still missing. To insert it, we select the rail route tool, click on the corresponding line and confirm. This completes the railing on the first side and we can delete the auxiliary geometry. Now we briefly tidy up the structure by moving the post to the railing assembly. Drawing railings is very fast with SolidSteel, but since our example is symmetrical, we can draw the second side even faster. To do this, we create a new work plane that we place in this direction, right in the middle of the claw. This is our symmetry axis over which we can mirror the complete railings assembly. Just define the direction and confirm. It's quick, isn't it? With this, our construction is completely finished. Now we can delete the work plane, clean up a bit, and that's the end of our little video series. I hope you enjoyed it and will watch again next time.